If you don't know, recently I moved. Today I'm going to show you how I transformed into what I would like to consider a bit of an urban jungle and a sanctuary where I could really enjoy my self-care routines. First and foremost, that started with the vanity area. So this was the bane of my existence. So the first thing that I did was I started to scrape away some of the like caulking or sealant that's around the sink. As you guys can see, it was really yellow and just generally not okay. So I went in with an X-Acto knife, removed the caulking that was actually on the sink itself, but I didn't take any out of the seam because it was kind of difficult. And then I went in with a silicone sealant that was actually white and I just filled that gap. As you can see, you don't have to be really perfect with it. You just want to get it on there. And then I went in with this Holy Grail product, which is a caulking tool. This 100% made this a seamless job. I got this perfect in one pass, so do highly recommend. I left it to dry and then I came back the next day. Oh my God, the medicine cabinet. It was the deepest cabinet I've ever seen in my life. It was like protruding like 10 inches from the wall, so I could not wash my face in the sink comfortably without turning my neck sideways. So took that off and then I replaced it with the Enudin from IKEA. However, I had a vision and that vision was not white because as you can see, it would just get lost. And also admittedly, this is smaller than I would have liked it to be, but this was $19.99. So while I wanted something bigger that would have ran me like $250, at least $300, my wallet was okay with 20 bucks. So we went ahead and just got some spray paint. Now, had I known that this actually came in more pieces, like in the corners you guys will see, instead of having that completely like seamless outline that's going around the mirror and creating that little lip, it does have some brackets that holds the mirror in place. And you can actually take them out. I didn't realize that at first. I didn't do that, but I would recommend that you do. And pro tip, if you lose any of your tape and it gets torn inside of the seam, then you can easily retrieve it with a good old-fashioned pair of tweezers. And by the way, I actually used washi tape to tape off the mirror. So if you don't have masking tape, literally washi is the same thing and you can buy it in the dollar section at Target. So you're welcome. I thought that this bathroom desperately needed some black to like ground it because like I said, so much white and then that mid-tone of gray, but nothing heavier to really make everything else stand out. So naturally from the mirror, I decided to go to the vanity slash storage area. And another thing that was bothering me, besides the color of this wood veneer, was this little strange window. This gray tone of wood is not my favorite. I would have loved to cover it, but I didn't think that I would easily be able to do so without damaging it. So I just settled for blocking out this little handle with some black washi tape. When I leave, I can just peel this off and it won't damage it whatsoever. However, it will cover that not quite chrome or silver, whatever that was. And now I could move on to actually decorating. So as I mentioned, I wanted to turn this into more of a jungle. One of the benefits to having all of these hospital white walls is that they would bounce light perfectly for having some living things in the space. So I thought it would be great to take these floor to ceiling glass panes and have some plants just trailing all the way down them. So I installed these shelves that I found on Amazon that just suction cup to the glass. And then I just stacked some white potted plants so that the white would blend into the walls. And then all you can really see is the vibrancy of the plant. And from here on, of course, I had to add more plants. So I decided to create some macrame hangers, which I'm gonna show you guys how I made right now. So all I did was take 6 strands of 3mm macrame cord and I cut them all to 58 inches long. I folded them in half so that they would create a loop in the middle, which is going to be the top of our suspension. And then I took an additional piece of cord, somewhere between 24 to 30 inches. So you want to leave a little bit of length at the top, bring it down and then back up like you see in the palm of my hand, and then start wrapping until you can't anymore and or you reach the loop that you created in the palm of your hand. Then you want to stick the end of your cord through that loop, then find the excess that you left at the top and pull it. And that'll just snatch up the end of your cord into the middle of your work so that it's secure and so that you can't see it. And to finish off, you can just snip the top cord that you pulled and then tuck it in with your finger or a pair of scissors in this case. So now to create the body of the hanger, I'm starting by taking 2 pieces of our string. And then you can do this step one of 2 ways. You can create an actual macrame knot by forming a number 4, layering your left side cord over your right side cord and then feeding the tail through and pulling, and you can do that twice to secure it, or you could just tie these into a traditional knot like I did. And then you just want to continue that until, of course, you have no more strings left and you have 6 knots. And then you want to take the pot that you intend to put into this and see roughly where I wanted my knots to stop, above or below the rim of the pot, and then roughly measured where the bottom of the pot would sit. I could just use a measuring tape to do this, but I'm lazy, we ain't got time for stuff like that. So roughly holding my cords at that point, I just repeated the same steps that I did at the top of the cord to finish it off, and you are done. And then all I did was separate the cords so that they created more of a triangle and really hugged the pot. And I also used that same wrapping technique using 2 different types of cord to contrast each other. I just put them onto a curtain rod that I got from IKEA, and you can go for white or you can choose a contrasting color, which in this case I did change these to black. Moving on to the shower, I wanted a shower stool so bad and finally settled on what is actually outdoor patio furniture, but is going to work for the time being and my ankles will appreciate while I massage scrub into my legs. Then I added some amber glass jars with some cleansing conditioner for my hair, also a DIY shower gel that I'm still testing out for you guys. And like I said, this is an oasis, so for the occasional spa treatment, I also added some eucalyptus. This is not something that I always have in my shower because they only last about a week, but if you do want to try it out, this is how. First, once you coat your hands with some kind of oil, coconut oil, olive oil, whatever you have on hand, because not only is the sap on these leaves super sticky, it can also be quite irritating. So especially if your skin is sensitive, you want to be careful. Some of these leaves can get pretty thick, so depending on what your bundle looks like, you might want to trim them down into some manageable pieces that are not too crazy and don't have too many stems, and then just bundle them together and then tie them off with some twine or whatever string that you have. You can even use embroidery floss. And then I just strung an additional piece through that so that I could actually hang it from my shower head. So how you do this is gonna really depend on your shower situation. Just make sure that the water is not actually touching the leaves. You really just want the steam from your shower to create an aromatherapy experience. So that's the purpose of it, not to take an herbal shower. So since I don't have a door to my shower and this is very open, of course things can get a little damp. So I decided to add a rug. And these really tall cabinets actually house my washer and dryer. So I went ahead and added this cute laundry bag from H&M. And this little worker basket that I toss my reusable cotton rounds into gives them a place to kind of air dry before I throw them into the laundry. And also added this cute little architectural waste basket. And then all there's left to do is just add your finishing touches, like your hand wash or your lotion and your toothbrush, you know. I took the liberty of adding even more plants into this space, and to be honest with you guys, I'm not even done. Like, I really want to add more plants, and there are some elements that I wanted to bring in that I just couldn't find the right thing. So make sure that you guys are subscribed so that I can update you when things change. But I hope you like it. I hope it gave you some inspiration for your space. And if you guys do decide to bring any of these elements into your home or incorporate in a different way, I would love to see them. I love seeing other people's perspective and how you add your own creativity. So please do tag me. If you're not already, of course, subscribe, because we have a lot more home and decor coming. And yeah, I'll see you in the next video. Bye.